Here we go! Peachy!
Here I go!
What's going on? We're back for another edition of the Funtendo Game Show, where we give you game, we talk about life, and we talk about everything that matters to you.
100%.
Let's jump right into the show. Today we're going to talk about cuffing season, what it is, when it is, and when people want to be uncuffed.
You've heard that before, right?
As we check out Merriam-Webster's dictionary, they define when is cuffing season, something to do during cold, dark months. What to know? Cuffing season refers to a period of time where single people began looking for short-term partnerships to pass the colder months of the year. Cuffing season usually begins in October and lasts until just after Valentine's Day. The use of the word cuff references handcuffs, but it is slang in the same vein as hooking up or getting hitched. So that's the formal definition of what cuffing season is. Let's check in over here with the actual cuffing season calendar and find out when that starts, when it ends, where we currently are in the cuffing calendar year.
I hate this job.
So according to the cuffing season calendar, fellas, I know you don't believe this calendar, but this is real. This is not a joke.
Shut your mouth.
This is actually what is happening, and people are following these calendars. There are a lot of women out here that are definitely scouting from August 1st to 31st. They're drafting right around the time the NFL is going to start out. There's tryouts in October during the first part of the NFL season and the basketball season. Then there's the preseason, getting ready for Thanksgiving. Then cuffing season officially starts. Now, in order for a woman to be successful during cuffing season, she's got to cuff you.
We're in the game.
She's got to be able to take you home for the holidays. She can't go home at Christmas and don't got nobody. She can't come over to her mama's house and she comes home alone for the seventh year in a row, but she's been on spring break every single year. Mom's going to be looking at her crazy. Brother's going to be looking at her crazy. Everybody's going to be looking at her like, you scumbag, sleazy.
Who are you?
Bag. So they absolutely have to do whatever it takes from December 1st to January 15th to cuff you.
I'm not mentioning no names.
Let's jump into playoffs, fellas. That's if you are lucky enough to actually have made the cut. A lot of you guys don't make the cut, so immediately after Christmas, they got a gift out of you. There was New Year's. They popped a bottle with you. They had somebody to kiss on New Year's. And now that's all over. That's a distant memory. Whatever money you spent, time invested, you spent, flowers, etc. You might not have made it this far. So if you did, congratulations, fellas. You at least made the cuffing season. Now, let's talk cuffing season playoffs for the guys that at least weren't completely gumpy, or maybe some of them were completely gumpy, but, you know, at least they made the cut. They were able to, you know, finesse their way through the cuffing season, and now they're in the playoffs. That's going to go from January 16th to February 13th.
I'm going to show you.
What do we have during this time period? The Super Bowl. Of course, once again, these ladies can't go home to the Super Bowl party. They can't show up at their best friend's Super Bowl party, and they ain't got nobody on their arm. They look like a low-value woman. So, what do they have to do? They got to keep you locked in during the playoffs, fellas. Duh, it makes sense. NFL playoffs, Super Bowl playoffs. Hello. Start thinking with this up here, fellas. So after the Super Bowl, we go near the championship game. This coincides right around the same type of the Super Bowl. I think this year the Super Bowl was right around there, maybe 2 days before the championship game. The championship game, fellas, is February 14th. Do you see how that coincides with Valentine's Day? So if you made it to Valentine's Day, congratulations. You made it to the championship round. That doesn't mean you're going to win, though. That does not mean that you are going to win. What it means is that you were just good enough. You showed up on Thanksgiving and you suffered through the dry turkey, Aunt Ruth's dry turkey. You showed up on Christmas. You had a gift in hand. You know, you bought her a little charm bracelet. You bought her a little necklace with the charm.
See that some harm comes to him.
You know, something for a vehicle. I don't know what you got her, but you got her something nice enough to advance to the playoffs.
Then you've learned your lesson.
If you didn't get no gift right here, brother, you didn't make it to the playoffs. Okay? You probably didn't even make it till New Year. So you probably got right on a couple days before New Year's Eve. And then maybe she went back out and tried to explore the possibilities and see what else she could come up with during the middle of cuffing season. Now, cuffing season is very, very scary out here for women. If they don't got nobody and it's cold outside and their girlfriends do and they have to start showing up at all of these events, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's Eve, and they ain't got no man, doesn't look good for them. All right, back to the championship game, fellas.
Okay.
Like I said, you might have made it to the championship, but you're not necessarily going to win the game. So you have to be prepared for whatever happens. There's a winner of the game and there's a loser.
We do not tolerate failure number three.
At least you didn't go out and blow the bag on the championship game. A lot of you suckers out here that were scouted back in August, you got drafted. Okay, you went through the tryouts, you made the cut in the preseason, and then you actually made the cut, the final roster for cuffing season.
100%.
You made the playoffs. You got to the championship game. Now, at this particular point, I know that your confidence is pretty sky high. You're feeling comfortable. You're feeling great. You bought flowers. You bought roses. You bought chocolates.
Don't cry. Don't cry. Don't cry. Don't cry.
And the day after the championship game, she dumped you on your face like a flat pancake.
This is reality.
And you're completely devastated. You go into a winter hibernation. You didn't see it coming. You didn't gain about 46 pounds just sitting around eating Doritos and box frozen lasagna and drinking Coke.
Shut your mouth, you thong wearing fatty.
Now, what's going to happen is, do you think these women are going to sit around and wait for you? Brother. They're going to be right back out there on the prowl because spring break is just around the corner. Okay, and they start getting that itch. They start getting, you know, a little bit itchy to get out here, to go see what's going to happen. The springtime comes. It starts getting warmer. Booty shorts start kind of come out. Daisy Dukes start coming out. People start wearing less. The mini skirts go on. The other skirts go on. The short beauty cute tops go on. Hair's getting whipped up. Makeup's looking fresh. The sun is shining. Tans are going to start happening depending on where you live. If you live in the cold states, probably not going to be getting a tan, but it's spring break time. Y'all get my point, fellas.
100%.
Now, spring break is going to coincide from February 15th to March 14th. That's when girls are going to go out and go get wild at spring break, potentially, or at least get ready for it. Girls are going to start talking to their other girlfriends. Hey, ladies, they've been planning this for months in advance. You're just the last to know. They've been planning this for like since back when scouting season started right here or draft season. This is when they started planning the spring break vacation, okay? After the championship game, things aren't really working out. I think we need a break. Maybe we should take a break for a little while. Then all of a sudden, you pop in on her Instagram or her other social media, her TikTok, and she's over here at spring break. You guys decided to give it a break from each other, but she's at that spring break down there getting broke off.
I hate to break it to you
guys. What you thought was finna happen, fool? She just broke up with you right after the championship game. Got her plans together, stacked up her little couple chips real quick during February, and then all the girls got together to go wild during spring break. The resigner spring break cuffing season schedule is from March 15th to April 15th. Right now, we are at March 18th. So resign or spring break just started up. So fellas, don't be surprised if your woman breaks up with you right now.
You're fired.
Because it's uncuffing season is about to start. They have to go on spring break right now and find a potential person to potentially cuff or just stay uncuffed for hot girl summer. Cuffing season is going to come up again right here where they're going to potentially want to get cuffed for the summertime. Because let's be honest, men, you guys got resources and you want to go out somewhere nice, right?
100%.
You want to take a woman out. You want to have a nice, beautiful woman on your arm so you can come in and at least look like you're important. You want to look like a high status man, even if you're broke. So you got to show up with somebody. Plus, you know, your homeboys are showing up. They got something on their arm. These other girls might not be that cute. It'd probably be some ugly ones mixed in, but at least they got something. So you don't want to be the only guy in your crew showing up for the barbecues that start up in April, May. Woo! You don't want to be the only person showing up for the camping trip, the couples camping trips, all the little types of events that are going to happen. So you settle for a lot less than you should be settling because a lot of times you have no discipline. You got dumped right here after the championship game. Here it is, 2 months later, and you're feeling drier than the Sahara Desert out here. You ain't seen no part of no woman. So now you done went out here and jumped on the first bus you saw, but that bus was going straight to hell. Now, getting back to April 16th to July 30th, 31st, the cuffed or uncuffed season is going to coincide with the end of spring and pretty much most of summer, most of official summer. Now, what's going to happen during this time period is women are going to want to go out. You're going to want to go out. You are either, if you're cuffed, you're going to have your girl on your arm. You're going to be trying to show her an amazing summer. This is our first year together. Let's take a weekend trip. Let's go to San Diego. Let's go to New York. Let's go to Orlando. Let's go wherever we're going to go. Let's go to Mexico, baby. Cabo San Lucas is so great. No. Let's go to Acapulco. Oh, well, she wants to go to Hawaii. Oh, let's go to Hawaii. Let's go to Maui. You have the money, right? Right? Don't you, baby?
No.
Now, if you're uncuffed, here's what's going to be happening. You're going to be out, hot boy summer, out here on the prowl, thirstier than ever, coming out with your tongue wagging out of your mouth out here like a dog. Desperate, thirsty, hungry, ready to jump on anything you can jump on out here. Because like I said, you ain't seen nothing since the championship game when you got dumped and she broke your heart on Valentine's Day. Now, for the ladies, here's how it's going to go. If the ladies are uncuffed, they're going to be out here having hot girl summer.
Here we go.
They're going to have went to the mall. They're going to have all their booty shorts lined up. They're going to have all their yoga pants lined up. They're going to have all their tight gym fits lined up. They're going to have all their thirst trap lined up. They done took new pictures. They done went and got a professional photographer. They done went and got Botox, fillers, plumpers, thumpers. They done went and got everything. They're fully ready, locked and loaded and prepared to be uncuffed for what may be a long, hot girl season for them. They're going to want to take trips to Miami with their friends. They're going to want to go to Las Vegas with their friends. They're going to want to go to LA, 100%. New York, London, Paris, anywhere they can go. And that's when you're going to see her when you're at home, uncuffed, swiping on your Instagram, looking at your ex over here in France, eating ham and croissant with fresh cheese and fresh hot tea with a picture of the Eiffel Tower in the background.
Yeah,
while you're sitting over here uncuffed. But you're going to actually see two glasses on the table instead of just one.
Wow.
Instead of one mimosa, you're going to see two mimosas. And she's going to have this smile on her face like that. And you're going to be wondering, who the hell is she with? So, That is the cuffing season schedule in a nutshell from your boy Funtendo, who's always going to keep it straight with you. I'm going to always give it to you raw, funky, uncut.
Then you've learned your lesson.
And I ain't never going to hold back on you. So, now that we've covered the cuffing season calendar, let's get into some of the other content here so we can see what's actually going on out here.
I'm going to show you.
We do not tolerate failure number three.
When people don't like me, it's because I said the truth.
Winter has arrived, y'all.
Temperature's dropping.
And you know what that means.
It's cuffing season.
Woo!
Keep us warm through these cold months.
But not just any man will do.
That's right. We out here looking for some
big boys.
You've heard that before, right?
Baby, I promise you this. I'll send you all my love.
Yeah!
Every day in a letter. Sealed with a kiss.
This hoes keep calling, I ain't picking up.
Yeah.
This hoes keep calling, I ain't picking up.
Yeah.
Hoes, I'll be back around June.
Around June.
Told these hoes, I'll be back around June.
Woo!
Better yet, I changed my numbers for the whole winter.
Woo!
Damn, it's so cold in the winter.
Woo!
Okay, let's hear from this young lady about spring fever. She's going to describe a little bit about what happens during the spring. You know what? I'm going to just let her tell it to y'all.
So I just thought I'd come on here and make a video talking about spring fever. So spring fever is like early spring, summertime. So now, basically.
You've heard that before, right?
Bunny owners might notice a change in their rabbit's behavior. And that is due to the rise in their hormones at this time of year. It's to do with like the days being longer and like the them being warmer as well, and it makes their hormones rise. And it
she's talking about rabbits, fellas, but the same thing applies to women too. So I'm gonna let the video play so y'all can hear the rest.
Some behavior problems. So at the minute, Lola is on one. She is just, I just can't even explain it. She's just going crazy.
Here we go.
And it can happen in neutered rabbits and unneutered rabbits. It's worse in unneutered rabbits, but in
what I'm trying to say is, like,
still happen. Lola's been neutered for years and she's going crazy. And as well, in bonded rabbits, you could have a pair of bonded rabbits that have been bonded for ages and they might now start having the occasional fight.
Here we go.
One's breaking up, and it does not mean you should separate.
Wow, 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 wow.
Then do, but it is just spring fever. Things to look out for is like digging, nesting. Humping and biting.
Mamma mia!
And just being generally moody, which is what Lola is at the minute. She's just grumpy. Like, she's just really grumpy.
Isn't it funny how everything that she said applies to women as well? Almost every single thing that she said. All right. You guys could be the judge of that.
Choose your next witticism carefully, Mr. Bond. It may be your last.
Simps, when cuffing season is over and they get dumped the day after Valentine's Day.
Oh my God. I am never going to financially recover from this. Oh my God. I am never going to financially recover from this.
Cuffing season is over. Who's getting dumped this month?
You're fired.
I don't know if I'll be okay tonight. I'll let you know in the morning. I'm sure you can tell that something isn't right. I'm sure you can tell. So I'm only like this sometimes. Going through hell. Go out and get some sunshine.
Cuffing season
is over and a lot of people are breaking up right now, but that doesn't mean you can't hang out with his mom still.
You weren't the one, but now that it's done, I still think your family's cool. If you wanna know how my life is going, there's somebody close to you and she already knows it. All my ex's moms listen to my songs. Yeah, they can't get enough, still keep in touch since I moved on. All my ex's moms only wish me well, but they hate their sons, all ended up with someone else. All my ex's moms.
Guys, you don't think this is real, but they're putting it right in your face. Cuffing season is over. I'll still talk to your mom, your father, your uncle, your aunt.
100%.
So I can keep getting information. Just in case I might need to wiggle my way back to you.
It doesn't matter what you think.
Shut your mouth.
But you guys don't think it's real.
I don't care.
But it's real, fellas.
100%.
Pay attention.
I'ma show you.
I don't want to be fixed up. I don't want a boyfriend. I'm young. It's fine. I'm 23. I don't need a man.
Shut your mouth.
This is Khloe Kardashian a while ago for those that don't recognize her. Did you hear what she just said? When uncuffing season started, she said,
I don't want to be fixed up. I don't want a boyfriend. I'm young, it's fine, I'm 23, I don't need a man. I'm good.
Peaches got it.
I don't want to be fixed up, I don't want a boyfriend. I'm young, it's fine, I'm 23, I don't need a man. I'm good.
It's uncuffing season right now. I don't want to be shackled up with you. I want to go out here and get on the carousel for a little while and play musical carousel. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, so let's go ahead and be real. I'm trying to give it to you guys straight. I know you probably ain't ready to hear that, but you came to the Funtendo game show where we give you game. We talk about life and we talk about everything that matters to you. So either you're going to shut your mouth and pick up your pen and pad and start learning some real game, or you're going to continue to keep living that same old life that you've been living and continue to get dumped after the championship game on Valentine's Day every year. Or your girl's just going to act up on you and then she's going to go to spring break on you.
We have no confidence.
Okay? This is real. Listen up. Pay attention.
We don't know what's happening. And it's got to stop. And it's got to stop fast.
Let's hear from this guy. He said, cuffing season is over.
And you know what that means.
And I might have to block out the portion of the video here for copyright, but I'll do that when I edit it because this is the Jerry Springer show. But let's listen to this player tell his story.
Izzy says he wants his freedom back. Izzy, what's going
here
on?
I go.
I'm here to get freed. I'm here to get my liberty back. Ooh. You know, cuffing season is over. It's dead. You feel
okay.
me? Like, I mean, I done got myself into this situation, and now I have to figure out how to get myself out of it. I have
Okey-dokey.
To get out. I'm cuffed down, and you know, I'm an artist. You know, it's about the cuffing season is done. It's about to be booty short season.
And I
gotta be feeling bad because I can't look. You know what
so
I mean?
So basically, you're in a relationship and you want out of it.
Man, yeah. And the thing about it is, I've been dealing with this girl for 4 years. You know,
it's a serious relationship.
Yeah, I mean, well, we decided to cuff 6 months ago. But before that, we were practically inseparable for 4 years.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
the thing about
it
was,
got it.
You know, my uncle told me that they give you signs. Yeah. You know what I mean? He told me, when you see those signs, run. And then that's basically,
what was the sign? What was the sign?
I mean, first of all, we got these things going on where, you know, I mean, I'm young, you know, I'm still going out.
You've heard that before, right?
The studio, I'm doing my thing. And
I don't care.
What happens is, I'm trying to enjoy myself and get my money. And what happens is, you know, she'd be calling me, you know, oh, what's going on? Who is that in the background? And I feel like, you know, I'm looking at myself in the bathroom, hiding, trying to get on the phone. And, oh, babe, it's not like that. And I'm like, 3 years ago, I would have been the guy that was making fun of
that
dude in the bathroom, hiding, being all bayed up. That one person at the table, everybody got booties in their face. And I'm the one dude over here with my phone trying to text. You know what I mean? And I'm like, it's time. You know, my fans, my people, they look at me, you know, to be a symbol for excess.
You're a musician?
Yeah. And being on the road, it's time to go out and enjoy myself. You know what I mean? I'm trying to go out there and get into it. And, you know, another thing is I kind of had a slip up.
Here we go.
And it.
All right, we ain't going to get into this fella slip up over here because that's a whole nother day for a whole nother conversation. But you heard my man say it. Cuffing season's over. It's time for me to get out here in these streets. I want to be free out here. Let's check in with this gentleman right here. Let's check in with this gentleman over here and hear what he has to say about, is it okay to take these trips without your spouse?
Today's question or topic of conversation is about trips.
Here we go.
A guy's trip, a girl's trip, that sort of thing.
I'm not mentioning no names.
Here's the scenario.
I'm not mentioning no names.
You are in a relationship, a serious relationship.
Yahoo!
You have a spouse, a husband or a wife, or a significant other. So you are in a committed relationship. Your spouse, your significant other, comes to you and says, hey, baby, me and the girls are taking a trip to Puerto Rico for a week.
Huh?
Hey, baby, me and the fellas are taking a trip to Puerto Rico for a week. Huh. Or Miami or Houston or New Orleans. Doesn't matter the destination. The point is, they're taking a trip for a week. Key is, without you, they're going with the girls or they're going with the guys. And you're going to be staying home. How does that fly? Is that okay? My thing is, if you're a couple, you have a significant other or a spouse, why are you taking trips without your spouse? You just going to take a trip with your girls and leave your husband or your significant other home?
Yeah, Peaches got it. Yeah, Peaches got it.
I don't know about that one. What are your thoughts? Today's question.
So, he gave a little bit of his brief opinion. I'm sure he had a lot more to say, but I know he wanted to keep it all the way funky with y'all, but he probably couldn't drop that type of heavy knowledge on y'all young bucks out here in this world because it would have been a little bit too much to go on your skinny back. He probably would have broke your back down out here. And now you got to call in sick tomorrow to work with your doctor's note. So, but I think what he was really getting at was that it probably ain't cool to have that type of scenario going on. You probably shouldn't be taking a girl's trip or a guy's trip. And it goes both ways. I ain't just going to say girls shouldn't do it. Guys shouldn't do it either if you're in a committed relationship. So, that's kind of what he thinks. That's a little bit about what I think. However, I do think if it's a family vacation or something like that, it should be okay to go with your family. But when it's specifically centered around your friends of the same sex and a big group of y'all going somewhere, it starts getting real dicey. Let's check in over here. Fort Lauderdale Beach, Wild Spring Break 2024. Let's go.
Here we go.
I don't know.
All right, I'm going to stop it right there. You get a little bit of a feel for what's going on down here. A lot of scantily clad people, both men and women. A lot of cheeks hanging out. A lot of bare skin being shown down here. A lot of thirsties on the boulevard down here, right off the beach. Looking thirsty. Tongues is wagging. After a couple of drinks, people cannot control themselves out here. So, is this where you want your significant other going with her friends? I don't think you probably do. Let's see what this news story has to say. Miami PD arrests hundreds for breaking curfew. Miami PD arrests hundreds for violating spring break curfew.
Miami police arrested hundreds of spring breakers despite implementing a curfew over the weekend.
Here we
go. Dana Marie McNichol has the latest.
Miami Beach has been cracking down on spring breakers, including a curfew that begins at midnight until 6 a.m. from Friday through today. Despite this curfew, the Miami Beach Police Department says they arrested more than 250 partygoers over the weekend. But this is still a drop from last year's mayhem that resulted in 500 arrests, the seizures of 105 guns, and two fatal shootings. Spring breakers in Miami say the rules are creating a different vibe compared to last year.
I don't like the curfew. It sucks.
Just cop cars lined up on every street.
You've heard that before, right?
I think it's better than all the other years.
The Miami Beach mayor calling the new regulations a win-win.
This is the calmest spring break we've had in years. We took the most robust measures we've ever taken by a long shot. This is actually a huge success for us this year.
So you hear what they're saying. They're cracking down on these spring breakers. Uncuffing season is in full swing and they have descended on Florida. They are hitting Miami. They're hitting Fort Lauderdale. They're hitting anywhere that's warm where they can get their drink on and get their party on. And it ain't nothing wrong with being young and partying or being old and partying as long as you're partying responsible. So that article just highlights a little bit about what's going on over there. Here's a little bit of normie humor. POV, you're going to Fort Lauderdale for spring break without your boyfriend.
Don't worry about it.
Say it again.
I just had to remind that you have a boyfriend.
Shut up. Why do you even remind me? What did I do to ever make you forget?
Yeah, I don't have to.
What do you mean?
He says it's because you're going with me.
You did something.
This dude probably bought her a I have a boyfriend t-shirt that she has to wear, or booty shorts. I have a boyfriend booty shorts on the back. So they know you got a boyfriend. Don't try to go down there and pretend like, babe.
You've heard that before, right?
Everybody knows I have a boyfriend. No, they don't. And you will be marked as a target, girl.
100%.
Ain't nobody thinking about your boyfriend back home.
I don't care.
If he is not absolutely present, he cannot win the lottery.
No.
I can hear the streets coming. I can hear the streets coming. I can hear the streets coming. I can hear the streets coming.
This lady has a hat that says, no boyfriend, no problem.
Prescription jugs.
When you go on vacation without your husband, what? Even the married ladies are getting in on the action? What is going on?
You've heard that before, right?
It's fun to stay at the bar.
Oh, she's acting right now, trying to make a couple little videos. Oh, baby, I was having fun, but I missed you, so I decided to come home early. Yeah, okay.
That was a nice one, okay.
Let's check in with this lady. She says, when cuffing season is over, let's let her run us down on what it really is.
You know how you could tell when cuffing season is over? When you get all these DMs.
I'd love that.
Talking about, I missed you.
Okie dokie.
I miss talking to you. I miss seeing your face.
Mamma mia.
And you know for a fact you've been laying low during cuffing season. You ain't really had nobody to cuff with. You know what I'm saying?
Ha.
And phone be super dry. Super dry. I'm talking about Sierra Desert guy. And then all of a sudden, bing, bing. And guess what time and what date that shit started? February 15th.
Thank you.
But I'm just saying, I think the ones that didn't have any, they definitely was circling the DM box.
Mamma mia.
Ain't no way. Ain't no way. Like Future say.
Because see, The Rock has already answered this time and time again.
I mean, if it ain't work before cuffing season, what the f- you think I want to spend my spring and summer with?
Wow!
So fellas, remember before I told you all of this is getting planned months and months in advance. Hot girl summer prep starts months and months ahead of time.
100%.
There's outfits that gotta be coordinated.
It's in my code.
The booty shorts have to go with the tank tops. The bikini bottoms have to go with the other tops and the sunglasses and the hats. They have to get their skincare routine together. They gotta get their makeup game together. They gotta save all of their money in the relationship while they're with you, so that they have extra money to get ready for hot girl summer, for spring break, for uncuffing season. Duh, don't you guys know this already? Let me go ahead and let this girl tell you about her hot girl summer prep.
Preparing for hot girl summer starts right now. 6 months from today, it's gonna be like May. So we need to start preparing right now.
Here we go.
If we wanna be looking snatched and glowing and amazing in the summer. So everything is based on our routine. So this is gonna be my morning routine. We're gonna do morning affirmations, face oil, do our face sculptor. I'll show you guys a device that I bought that is actually like working wonders. Skincare, sip on some warm bone broth, warm apple cider vinegar water, chai latte. I'll show you guys the recipe for that. That's really good for snatching your waist. Aloe shot, probiotics, Brazil nuts, beauty water, minerals, and journal. Evening, we're not playing around. We're gonna dry brush towards the heart. We're gonna take a hot bath or shower. We're gonna do our gua sha. We're gonna do our skincare. We're gonna read and we're gonna put our legs up against the ceiling for circulation. I'll go into depth.
Hold on. What? We're gonna put our legs up in the air for circulation?
Here,
I don't know. I think she might be practicing for something else.
Yeah!
We're gonna work out. We're gonna try to hit 10K steps a day at least. And then cardio if we want, and a lot of Pilates. And then diet, high protein, low carb. If you guys want me to go into depth and show you guys the things I bought, let me know.
Here we go!
All right, fellas. So, I broke that down earlier.
I'm gonna show you.
We ran through the cuffing season schedule. We talked about spring break. We talked about the Valentine's Day heartbreak when you made it to the championship and you lost the big game. Hopefully you didn't lose the bag when you got broke up with on the championship game. But if you did, you still got time to recover. You're young. You're young out here. You'll be able to get it back.
I don't think so.
Don't make that mistake next year again. Go ahead and take note of the cuffing season calendar so you can know when things start going funny. Like the other woman earlier highlighted, mood start changing, hormonal changes, it's getting warm outside. All of those same things that this woman was applying to her rabbit seem to hold true for our species as well. So let's move into the next video and see what this girl has to say.
Okay.
But wait, there's more.
I have a boyfriend.
That's Cap.
So hot. Yeah.
It's
a
boyfriend. It's an evil world we live in, but hey, I'm gonna keep living.
It's a hot girl summer. My boyfriend just broke. We just broke up like 3 weeks ago.
So you've been running up the scoreboard.
Hell yeah.
How many points have you added to the scoreboard?
Too many. There's no limits to it, bruh.
I can help you over there.
Okay, bet. You want my number?
Yeah.
I'll give you my number.
Come on, man. That's too easy.
Can I be honest with you, bro?
What's up?
You're the reason I have trust issues with females.
Know your role and shut your mouth because the people's champ is ready to talk.
It's not a lie as long as you believe it. They're putting it right in your face. Fellas, you gotta love social media. Forget about all these thirst traps they got out there. Suck up the knowledge. Previous generations never had it as good as we have it right now. The total truth about the true nature of the woman is being exposed, and they're doing it voluntarily. No holding back.
Oh, thank you very
much.
We
got TikTok. We got Snapchat. We got InstaThought. We got it all, bro.
The Rock has already told you.
We got it all. And I'm bringing it to you live and funky. From Funtendo Game Show.
100%.
Let's go. This woman says, decided to invite all of my hinge dates at once and let them battle it out. Really? Now, fellas, let's talk about it. Even if you had a roster, which a lot of you guys don't.
I must be dreaming.
Let's say you did have a roster and you had six thoroughbred stallions on your roster, and they was all trying to compete to win the Kentucky Derby.
I must have appealed to a maternal instinct.
Do you think you could get away with inviting all six of them out at once? They would literally either be slicing each other's throats and choking each other, or you would end up deleted at that particular date for thinking, for having the audacity to think you could bring out six different women. Not unless you're some billionaire, but if you're a regular dude out here, don't even try it. But for women, this is common behavior. There's women out here that are reckless.
I hate to break it to
you
guys,
but I'm gonna let her show it to you. One goofy, two goofy, three goofy, four goofy, five. Really? You guys are that thirsty. And look at her behind the beer that she didn't pay for. Smirking at you guys like she's got a room full of gumpy gump gumps over here. I got my pick of gumps tonight. I'm having gumpo soup tonight. And wow, you guys are gumpy enough and thirsty enough to participate in this activity. Get your game together. Come back to the Funtendo Game Show and come get you some game. Because you guys are lame out here doing this. If I ever go anywhere and I see this type of behavior, I'm going to have to come up and investigate further and find out what's going on. Okay? That's just how it's going. But again, fellas, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink it. You heard it from the ladies. You heard it from the gentlemen. Cuffing season is over. Spring break is here right now.
Yeah!
And hot girls, hot guys, summer is just around the corner.
100%.
That's going to wrap it up for today's episode of the Funtendo Game Show, where we give you game, we talk about life, and we talk about what's important to you. When you got game, life ain't the same.
100%.
Let's just be honest.
Say what you tell.
Let's just be real.
Say one time.
You ain't got no cash.